morning. Today is August 17th, 2020. My name is Father Trav, and I would like to welcome you to today. As usual, before we begin, I would like to remind you that we upload new episodes every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 6 a.m. Also, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon to be notified whenever new episodes are uploaded. With that out of the way, my friends, let's begin. My brothers and sisters, this morning I would like to ask you the following questions. What does the word bold mean to you? What does the word bold mean to you? Secondly, what does it feel like to be bold? What does it feel like to be bold? And my third and final question is this. What is a bold next step that you would like to take in your life? What is a bold next step that you would like to take in your life? Dana Owens, better known by her stage name Queen Latifah, an American rapper and actress, encourages us by saying, be bold, be brave enough to be your true self. For you see, Matthew's Gospel chapter 14, verse 26 through 31 tells us of the boldness of one of Jesus' apostles. It reads as follows. When the disciples saw Jesus walking on the sea, they were terrified. It is a ghost, they said, and they cried out in fear. At once Jesus spoke to them, take courage, it is I, do not be afraid. Peter said to him in reply, Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water. He said, come, Peter. And Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water towards Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened and began to sink. He cried out, Lord, save me. Immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and caught him and said to him, oh, you of little faith, how did you doubt? Friends, we all have moments in our life when we wonder what the next step is. Where do we go from here? Is it safer to stay where I am and risk never improving, or step out into the uncharted water and elevate ourselves to new heights? You see, friends, today we find Peter sinking and he shouts out, Lord, save me. Have you ever cried out those words from the depths of your hearts? And I say those words personally, repeatedly throughout my life. Whenever I felt myself sinking into choppy waters, you see, friends, our entire life by God is an invitation to step out of our proverbial boat. Even more, we have to learn that this invitation is the only one that matters, and we need to respond to it if we want to attain sanity in our lives. You see, friends, we, like Peter, are humans. And yet, Jesus beckons us to walk on proverbial water. You see, this gives us hope, for we do not need to be perfect to answer his invitation. We need only to have faith and to be willing to answer when he proposes something different than what we think we need in our lives. You see, friends, we only have one life. And we must live it in being true to who we are and what God has called us to be. Friends, I encourage you today now to join me as we carry our lives to God in prayer. Let us pray. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Gracious God, you call us to let go of the things we cling to and step out in faith, trusting in your love and provision. Please give us the courage to step out boldly and sufficient confidence to follow without fear. Take our lives and our gifts, use them to accomplish more than we can imagine, so that through us, your kingdom might come and your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Amen. Friends, Christ says, come, experience my glory. Come, live in my love. Come, be like me. Come, walk on water. The question of the day is, are you willing to step out boldly in faith? As usual, I would like to thank you for tuning in. And as we always say here, make today your best day. Until we meet again.